William, hopefully your favorite videographer from Two Hats Publishing. I welcome you to another Two Hats special of community events. Let's look in and see what's really happening.
My name is Cosette Kosery and I work with Real Life Connection. Today we are celebrating Transgender Day of Remembrance, and I am here honoring the lives of 23 youth who have passed away either via suicide or homicide.
Okay. Sounds good.
Alright.
Thank you.
That's how we
I know the wind is kind of kicking up, but I want to thank you all for coming. I know that the weather is gonna hold up, but at least I have faith that it will. I want to welcome y'all to the Black Trans Advocacy Center, or TDOR, which is Transgender Day of Remembrance 2015. Just to give you a little bit of history about
over her dead body,
if you aren't familiar with it. Started in 1999 with a candlelight vigil in San Francisco organized by Gwen Steele to call attention to the still unresolved murder of Boston's Rita Hester, which occurred on November 28, 1998. And the unacceptable media that misgendered Rita happened in the wake of it all. So the individuals that set up the TDOR were very infuriated with the trans people at the time. And the media for misgendering Ms. Hester. And it even happened in the gay-owned newspaper, so that, I think, made it just a tad bit worse. The list normally contains the individuals that were that lost their lives as a result of murder. And this year, we're going to do something a little different because we're going to include all of the youth that have taken their lives, which it's been a devastating year. So a lot of the TDORs, they don't include that, but our TDOR is going to be special and that we're going to bring attention to that this year. So I have a few statistics. The total number of trans women victims just in the United States, and someone correct me if I'm wrong, but I have 23. And of those 23, 19 of them were trans women of color. Brazil, for some reason, is one of the deadliest places for trans individuals. For the past few years now, the list has just been overwhelming with individuals. So however, in this year, we don't have the signs or the pictures of the individuals, but we did want to make it known that Brazil is one of the more deadlier places. We are focusing our attention on the states and our youth this year. At this time, I would like to go ahead and bring up Ashley Boucher, who's a wonderful musician, who's gonna sing for us.
I didn't bring any sound equipment, so I guess I'm gonna busk it tonight a little bit.
Stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Why don't you stand? Stand by me. Stand by me. In the sky I look upon will crumble and fall, and the mountains should tumble to the sea. I won't cry, I No, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Why don't you stand? Stand by me. Stand by me. Darling, darling, stand by me.
Everyone should be familiar with that one, but I've got one more I want to do. It's written by this great band I love called the Okro Medicine Show. I've sung it a few times, but I don't know, it speaks a lot to me, so.
We made some signs up at the BTAC office. If you all would, please, by all means, grab one. It has photos of the individuals, the teens, Thank you so much. We have some more over here. Can you girls help me out with those, please? Are you, where are you? At this time, we're gonna have CD Kirvin come up and say a few words. And this is in reference to the violence and the mishaps that have been taking place here in the Oakland area.
Hello, everybody. I just wanna say a prayer for all our trans brothers and sisters that have passed over this last year, for the two that have been caught up in the recent violence. For the people in Paris, and the ones in the hotel that happened today, it was 20 Americans found in that. And I want to say our thoughts and prayers are with their loved ones and their families. But we are here as loved ones and families. We're coming in peace and calm with some demands. Some demands for those lives that we've lost. Some demands for the futures we never got to see. I'm sure most of you know, since September, we've had 12 attacks happen in our community, and several that went unreported. I've had several trans people who say they didn't feel safe reporting to the police because they didn't feel like it was being taken seriously. So 12 that we know about, but several others that go on, that go unreported, that we don't know about. And I want to say that, you know, we as a community have to stand up. Sometimes, and we've learned throughout history, sometimes we have to call upon the strength of ourselves to say no more. We have to call upon the strength of each other to say no more. We are not going to allow 13 to happen. We are not going to allow the violence to continue. We want to make demands on our mayor. Mayor Rollins, I hope you're listening to us. We are tired of words, because you know, all of you, that if 12 people were beaten and attacked in Highland Park, there would be police everywhere. There would be no 13. We all saw in the news where Katie Trails is resolved. You have a few people who want to be a little crazy and open carry, and then all of a sudden they find them, right? They look at the ATM video. They get serious about finding the attackers. But here, we're at 12 and we have no answers. No arrests, no suspects, no suspect descriptions, no descriptions of the car. All we have is a handful of excuses. And now we have a young man who was getting off of work at the tap house of Cedar Springs and was beaten within an inch of his life last night. He has a cracked skull and he's in ICU. This happened last night. There's still blood on the curb. But what we gotta ask ourselves is, do we take action when it becomes us, or do we take action now?
Now.
Do we demand justice when it's convenient for others, or do we demand justice now?
Now.
We need to look through this, one thing. I don't care if nobody told you. I love you. You are my family. And I'm sick and tired of these cowards coming down here, putting their hands on my family. Am I alone in this?
No!
We are going to call on ourselves, and I'm going to step off this just a second locally and go nationally. You people need to register to vote if you ain't voting.
All right.
Don't come out here holding signs, singing Kumbaya, landing candles, and praying for 10 seconds and going back to your home getting drunk and not paying attention. We have some people out there who are trying to undo everything we've done.
Every election matters.
I'm going to tell you something. Senator Ted Cruz, who's calling on our president, popping off and all this other stuff. Pop off down here, Ted Cruz. Because we are also voters. We are also your constituency. And when you sit up in a room with pastors that say gays and lesbians and transgenders should be killed, then I, as a constituent, have a problem with that. I have a doubt that you are even a legitimate candidate. Why don't you show us where your mama registered you in Canada? Everybody wants to see Obama's long birth certificate. I want to make sure you're an American and that you are not illegally holding that Senate office. Now, I done got off on that right there. And I did that because national politics are not the only politics that matter, people. If anything, that these 12 violent crimes, whether they were robberies, attacks on gay people, because I'm telling you, I've spoken to some of the victims, and they were attacked, called fags, gays, everything else under the sun, and the robbery was an afterthought. Kicked them and then stole their money from them after they beat them and called them all kind of names. I've had lesbian women say that they was touched inappropriately when they was assaulted, and they didn't feel like reporting it because they didn't think anybody would take it seriously. It's time for us as a community to go down there to our representative. Start there. You know, if you don't know who your city council person is, find out. And then after that, we need to go to a city council meeting and we need to say, Mayor Mike Rollins, we demand of your time. Mayor Mike Rollins, we demand that you start working with the police to start taking this. I don't think that they're not doing their job. Let me just say that. I work hand in hand with the police as an activist all the time. I'm going to tell you I don't think they're not doing their job. But we are just barely doing our job for showing up for something like this, a handful of people. We see what it feels like when you barely do your job. We need to go above and beyond in making demands. The police need to go above and beyond in making demands. The victims need to go above and beyond in making demands. Because before you know it, in another month, it'll be 24 instead of 12. And you may be one of the 24. And then these things always have a tendency to escalate. We'd be talking about attacks, and the next thing we'll be talking about is murder. I'm calling on our mayor to once again step up into your authority, step up into your humanity, and help us stop these attacks on our community. Because if you don't, and I don't know if they gave it to you, everybody, but I made these.
Poorly, I see.
This is what we become.
Artists, yep.
When we do nothing. This is what happens when we do nothing. You become a sitting target. And unfortunately, here we are as a community mourning the loss of too many sitting targets. I'm so grateful that it's a diverse community coming out here saying, because most of the victims of these crimes were trans women of color. And to me, it's hurtful that more of their families and more of the people that love them are out here demanding justice. But we are the extended family. We know what we had to do to be proud and get married and go to the club without hardly any interruption unless you count the 12 attacks. We know what we had to do. We had to come from those backdoor clubs and plant our flag in front of everybody and demand the rights that we so hardly deserve, that we work so hard for and that are born with us. You are not asking for nothing that does not belong to you. It's time we stop apologizing and we start demanding. This is my house. This is my family. This is my life and it belongs to me. And you haters cannot have it. My pride, you cannot have it. Their spirits, you cannot have it. But if you want that, if you need that, and if these deaths matter to you, and we are going to resonate in a demand that calls upon the purpose of these lives, we have to start demanding that from the right people. You can't just pretend like it doesn't exist because the world is overwhelming. Because so much is happening, you turn the TV off and you tune out. But when you tune out, people die. When you tune out, you lose your rights. When you tune out, you become a target. Take these home with you. And when the May registration, when the May votes come, when the November votes come, call upon the memories of this night. Call upon the memories of me trying to stir up in the spirit of you that you deserve to live free from attacks. That you deserve the rights as an American citizen that you were born to be married, to love, to have children uninterrupted. That you deserve to go to a hospital and hold the hand of the person you love when they die. And if they leave you everything, then you get everything. These are the things that belong to you that someone took from you and now that you want back. And for the lives of these people, the lives of our loved ones and our trans brothers and sisters that have left us way too soon with too much promise, call upon yourselves to turn it on, to vote, and to demand from the police and your mayor the right to feel safe in your own neighborhood. Stop being a target. Thank you, my brother, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you, CD, for that powerful, powerful message. We also have here tonight, going to be our guest speaker, is the mother of Tye Underwood. We did speak with her just a minute ago, and she's en route. So to keep the program moving, we're going to have Candace the Great share a spoken word piece with us. Candace?
Can y'all see me? Can you hear me? So I borrowed this. That's better for me. I borrowed this target and I'm gonna hold it over my heart. I had everything that I was gonna say planned out in my head. I worked it out, but I took a lift over here today. That's where you call a ride. Right, they pick you up, they drop you off wherever you're gonna go. When you get in the car, you're supposed to tell them where you're going. So I told them a guy, his name is Brent, I told him where I was going. And he said, "You going to a restaurant?" I said, "No. I'm going to a day of remembrance. It's a rally. It's important. So if you could get me there, I'd appreciate it." And he said, "But that's on Cedar Springs." I said, "I know. That's where my people are." He said, "You're black." I said, "I know. That's where my people are." He said, "Black people don't go on Cedar Springs." I can't make this shit up. I'm so serious. He said, "Black people don't go on Cedar Springs." I said, "Yes, we do." I said, we go on Cedar Springs. Black people, trans people, straight people, queer people, mean people, racist people. I said, everybody goes on Cedar Springs, whether they want to or not. No matter what called them there or not, they all go. When I tell you this man stopped his car, he stopped his car on the service station of 35. And he said, "Get out." He said, "Get out." I said, "I would, but I got somewhere to be." I said, "I would, but I respect you enough to tell you to keep driving, because that's what I'm paying you to do, to drive me where I need to be." I said all of that to say, people, it's real out here in these streets. It's real out here in these streets. I'm 30 years old and I've never had somebody to tell me get out because of where I was going. I'm paying for a service and they told me to get out. He told me to get out. So today I'm gonna tell all of you, get out of your comfort zone, get out of your silence, get out of your feelings, get out of your emotions, get out of your past, and get out of your present, because your future is not promised. Tonight I was almost number 13. And I'm not trans, but I'm gay as hell. And tonight I had a number on my life because of two words, get out. So this piece I'm gonna share with you is straight from my heart. And I'm gonna call it, "Can You Hear Me?" Voice that got muffled by knives and bats and tire iron. These tears are for all of my friends who don't get to inhale and exhale like I do. These tears are for my brothers and for my sisters who unfortunately were born in the wrong bodies. These tears are for their mothers and their fathers who cast them aside. These tears are for the churches that we're supposed to be home to all of God's children. Yet somebody outnumbered them. Somebody outsmarted them before they woke up. Somebody outlived them. These tears are for them. Can you hear me? Can you hear the hurt in my voice? Do you hear my heart crying out to you? Can you hear me? I know you remember what I looked like when I would smile, when I felt free wearing lipstick and mascara. MAC, they made that for me. I know you remember what my laugh sounded like when I held hands with the love of my life. When we walked down Cedar Springs, I know you remember. Can you hear me? They didn't give me the funeral that they gave everybody else. I was cremated because I disgraced my family. I was cremated because no one wanted to claim my body. I was cremated because the morgue is flooded with other trans brothers and sisters who don't have any place to call home. Can you hear me? because I hear you. Every time you call me freak, abomination, when you call me the Antichrist, when you call me a fag, when you tell me I don't belong, when you tell me that the world is better off without my name, I hear you. Every time that you don't speak up, I hear what you're not saying. Every time that you don't fight for me, I hear what you're not saying. I hear you telling me that my life doesn't matter as much as yours. I hear you telling me that my fight is not worth fighting as much as yours is worth fighting. I hear you telling me that if I can just blend in, tomorrow can be my friend. But can you hear me? When I tell you that it's not God's fault that I was born in the wrong body, that this journey is mine for the taking, and that every step that I take is numbered and ordered. Can you hear me? When I tell you that I matter. Can you hear me when I tell you that I respect you, and all I want is for you to respect me? I don't need your pity. Can you hear me? I don't need your sorrow. Can you hear me? I don't need your agony. Can you hear me? I don't need your grief. Can you hear me? All I need is your respect. I got the rest. All I need is your respect. I have the rest. All I need is your respect. Can you hear me? All I need is your respect. Can you hear me? All I need is your respect. Can you hear me? All I need is your respect. Can you hear me? I show people.
One more time, give Candace the greatest of hands. No one should never have to endure that. So I'm so grateful for all of you that are out here taking a stand with us. At this time, I'm going to ask if Cosette Kosari would come up with Real Life Connections. She and some of her youth are going to be helping us with the reading of the names for the teens.
Homeless youth. We're looking for food if any of you cook. We're looking for side dishes.
This event will be helping two local shelters currently, and we have also extended the invitation to about 200 LGBT youth in the community.
Hi, my name is Ashton. I'm from QYC's Queer Youth Coalition. We're a coalition of GSAs around the area that's run solely by youth, and I am on the service. I'm the service executive member for our service team. And that's about it. We meet with RLC every 2 weeks, and we're definitely coming up with some great stuff.
Thank you both so much. The list did include some that were over the age of 21, but I thought that it would be remiss if we did not include them in the list of those that have taken their lives. As I was saying earlier, at any rate, whether the individuals took their own lives as a result of misgendering or bullying or not being able to get their medications, I think that society has played a part in taking their lives. And you all are here tonight because you are taking a stand with us. And I thank you once again. Ms. Underwood is not here at this time, so Ashley, would you mind gracing us with another song? And if, while Ashley's singing, we're going to be passing out the candles. If you do not have one at this time, please let us know.
You almost had it.
Singing in the dead of night, take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arrive. Blackbird singing in the dead of night, take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You are only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird fly, blackbird fly into the light of a dark black night. Blackbird fly, blackbird fly into the light of a dark black night. Blackbird singing in the dead of night, take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise.
I was going to say, I don't know if I know all the words of this one, but in traditional fashion for a rally such as this, there were a lot of great songs written in the 60s, and Bob Dylan had some good ones, so. Thank you.
Come gather round people wherever you roam, and admit that the waters around you have grown, and accept it that soon you'll be drenched to the bone. Time for you is worth saving, so you better start swimming or you'll sink like a stone, for the times they are changing. Come writers and critics who prophesy with your pen, and keep your eyes wide, the chance won't come again, for soon and the wheel's still in spin. The old world is rapidly aging, just get out a new one if you can lend a hand, for the times they are changing. Come senators, congressmen, please heed the call. Don't stand in the doorway, don't block up the hall, for he who gets hurt will be he that has stalled. And the time for you is worth saving. Soon shake your windows and rattle your walls, for the times they are changing. Come mothers and fathers throughout the land, and don't criticize what you can't understand. Your sons and your daughters are beyond your command. Your old world is rapidly aging, just get out a new one if you can lend a hand, for the times they are changing. For the times they are changing.
Thank you so much for that, Ashley. And Candace the Great has another piece that she's going to be doing for us at this time.
Closer. Can you hear me okay? Sorry, I'm battling a nasty bug. Standing in the snow of my emotions, I feel your fire kindled by the wood of her. Even though her used to be him, I smell cedar kissing the pine of availability. I hear the crackling of their laughter, both of them residing inside of me, sparking smiles across my Mona Lisa. Standing in the snow of my emotions, I feel your soul tugging at my hands, begging for a knock at heaven's door. The emporium interest awaits greatness. Then all I hear is screams. They start like a whisper. They get louder. Each day that passes without a resolution, they get louder. Each day that passes without continuation of what our fathers started, they get louder. They say, your fathers, what fathers? The forefathers? No, not those fucks. They didn't give a fuck about us in the first place. I'm talking about our trans fathers, our gay fathers. It doesn't make sense, right? Because everybody stemmed from somewhere, the creation. They say it took a father, but it could have also taken a mother. I think she was actually asexual myself, able to reproduce and bring things upon us like greatness and self. Hands up, please, don't shoot. Hands up, please, don't shoot.
see, that used to be only a black thing because they said that only black lives matter, but now black people aren't the only people fighting for their lives because all lives matter. But that's what they want you to believe, that all lives matter. But all lives don't really matter. Because if all lives matter, then we wouldn't be standing here having this rally saying stop the violence, because trans lives matter, but they want you to believe that all lives matter. Ass prints flood both sides of Main Street like the Million Man March have met cockroaches' feet. My nigga is the new I love you. Paying attention is another respect to seeing us playing the Clarence Thomas part, but they want you to believe that all lives matter. All lives don't matter. Smoke and mirrors. Smoke and mirrors. Smoke and mirrors, it masks the new systemic reconstruction. Closed minds aid in inner race destruction. Dick dollars and pussy coins cause fake protesters to make lemons from imaginary lemonade, selling it to children who are not being taught better, dedicated to hashtags and pointless memes they call dumb. Did you get it? Because CNN is watching, right? All lives matter. That's what they want you to believe. All lives don't matter. That's why we're here, because all lives don't matter. Our lives don't matter to them, but if our lives don't matter to us, then they'll never matter to them. Our lives don't matter. But that's what they want you to believe, that our lives matter. Our lives don't matter. Our lives don't matter. Not to them anyway. Not to them anyway. Not to them anyway. Our lives don't matter to them anyway until we get in their way. Then our lives matter, because we're in their way, and all they want us to say is our lives matter. But our lives don't matter. That's why we're here, because our lives don't matter. Our lives don't matter, not to them anyway. They make jokes about the revolution being televised while cold brown skin fades to blue again. Remember through smudged fingerprints on the morgue glass, faint heartbeats and visions of cake-filled grins fade to cement cracks. Subliminal whips crack oppression on our backs. But our lives don't matter. That's the new mantra, our lives don't matter. But they want you to believe that all lives matter. Truth is now a figment of the trans man's imagination. Empire is the weekly destination, yet no one is listening to the cries of us, a young nation. Not young because our age and number says so, young because this movement is just now being birthed. Our lives don't matter. The suicide note found neatly written on the steel sheet, of which they both released and brushed their teeth and said, I'm going, since I left for her, which was really him, both of them really being me, because somebody told me that I didn't matter. But my inside said that I did matter. And the struggle became real. The struggle became real. The struggle became real, so I changed my name. The struggle became real, so I changed my name. The struggle became real, so I changed my name. Say my name. What's their names? Never forget. All lives don't matter. All lives don't matter. All lives don't matter. All lives don't matter. They said it was our fault because HIV was brought upon us by us, but we didn't start sleeping with ourselves and passing this shit around. Somebody brought it into us because they themselves couldn't be themselves. But they want you to believe that all lives matter. Our lives don't really matter. So I sit, we sit like flies on the wall, waiting for the next rally, waiting for the next Democrats' call. But we all asses. We're all asses. And at the same time, we're all the elephant in the room. So what does that mean? Democrats and Republicans can't get along, but we're all asses and the elephants in the room. So that means that we do get along to some extent, even though all lives don't matter. Like a fly on the wall, we sing the song for our brothers who've fallen. Like a fly on the wall, we sing the songs for our sisters who are gone. But they want you to believe that all lives matter. All lives don't matter until you take that bitch by the horns and make her your bitch. What bitch am I talking about? I'm talking about Congress. See, they said that they don't understand my English, so I use the vernacular that they use behind closed doors, and I curse just a little. I use the words that they call us behind closed doors. Out here on the streets with you, I cuss just a little, hoping that they'll understand. If I say it in Spanish, will it make sense? Maybe I should just say pray for Paris and we'll get some attention. Maybe I should say pray for Kenya and we'll get some attention. Maybe I should start screaming Boko Haram from the tops of my lungs and maybe we could get some attention. Maybe if I said I'm gonna start shipping my shit over to Cuba, then I could get some attention. Cause you know, they really don't like them anyway. They just need that embargo that they got going on, but all lives matter. All lives don't really matter. Until lives matter to ourselves, then all lives don't matter.
Ashe. Thank you for that. Everyone, if you could, one more hand for Candace the Greatest. Thank you so much for that. I know that the wind is blowing, and I appreciate you all for trying to light your candles. If you would like to try again, by all means, we will begin the reading of the names at this time. I thought that it would get easier each year to do this, or the burn wouldn't be as bad, but please bear with me. Gizzy Fowler, 24 years old. Cause of death, shooting. Nashville, Tennessee, November 12, 2014. Deshonda Sanchez, 21 years old. Cause of death, shooting. Los Angeles, California, December 3rd, 2014. Kamori Johnson, 24 years old. Cause of death, shooting. Albany, Georgia, December 6th, 2014. Poppy Edwards, 20 years old. Cause of death, shooting. Louisville, Kentucky, January 9th, 2015. Lamia Beard, 30 years old. Cause of death, shooting. Norfolk, Virginia, January 17, 2015. Tye Underwood, 24 years old. Cause of death, shooting. Tyler, Texas, January 26, 2015. Yasmin Payne, 33 years old. Cause of death was stabbed and burned. Van Nuys, California, January 31st, 2015. Teja De Jesus, 36 years old. Cause of death, multiple stab wounds. San Francisco, California, February 8, 2015. Penny Proud, 21 years old. Cause of death, shooting. New Orleans, Louisiana, February 10, 2015. Bree Golick, 22 years old. Cause of death, stabbed. Akron, Ohio, February 13, 2015. Christina Gomez Brandwell, 46 years old. Cause of death has not been established. Miami, Florida, February 15, 2015. Sumaya Yisi, 26 years old. Cause of death not known. Toronto, Canada, February 22nd, 2015. Keisha Blige, 33 years old. Cause of death, shooting. Aurora, Illinois,
March 7, 2015. Vanessa Santia of Miami, Florida, 33 years old. Cause of death, beaten to death in Fulham, England. She died on March the 28th, 2015. London Chanel, 21 years old, was stabbed to death in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania on May 18, 2015. Mercedes Williamson, only 17 years old, beaten to death in Rocky Creek, Alabama on May 30th of 2015. Jasmine Collins, only 25 years old, was stabbed to death in Kansas, Missouri on June 23rd of 2015. Ashton O'Hara, 25 years old, was stabbed to death and ran over by a vehicle in Detroit, Michigan on July 14th. India Clark, only 22 years old, died from a gunshot wound to her head and her arm in Tampa, Florida on July 21st of 2015. Casey Hager, 66 years old, died of multiple stab wounds in Fresno, California on July 24th of 2015. Shade Shuler, 22 years old. Her cause of death was unknown. She was found dead in a field here in Dallas, not far from where we stand, on July 29th of 2015. Amber Monroe, barely 20 years old, died of a gunshot in Detroit, Michigan on August 8th of 2015. Candace Capri, 35 years old, died of a shooting in Phoenix, Arizona on August 11th of 2015. Tamara Dominguez, 36 years old, of Kansas City, Missouri. She was repeatedly ran over by a vehicle until her death on August 15th of 2015. Alicia Walker, 20 years old, was beaten to death in Salisbury, North Carolina on August 15th of 2015. Zella Ziana, 21 years old, was shot to death in Gaithersburg, Maryland on October 16th of 2015. This completes our readings of the names, and I want us to have a moment of silence as we hold the candles up and light for the lives that we've lost. I'd also like to say that it's really hard to accept the death of anyone that we love. But when you hear that the cause of death is such horrific things like gunshot wounds, multiple gunshot wounds, ran over by a car, stabbed to death, burned to death, left in a field. These are our brothers and sisters that are being treated inhumane, discarded like trash. Before the deaths, we need action. We don't need to take action once we hear about it and put them on a list of names that we read every year. We need to take action until this list no longer exists. It's getting longer every year. We cannot bear to memorialize not one more of us. I am you and you are me. We are all equal. All lives matter. And as a trans community, we have courage. Every one of the people on this list of names every day lived with courage. Just to live freely as a transgender person, unaccepted, takes courage. These people don't represent timidity. They represent courage. They represent hope. And they represent a will to live freely. I encourage my trans brothers and sisters to never cower
never cower from your right to live freely, authentically, and fearlessly. I'd like to take a moment of silence just to thank the people on this list of names. We thank you for teaching us how to believe in ourselves, how to be brave and live fearlessly. We hope that your courage and your strength and your beauty can one day be reflected in all of us that are here living today. I'd also like to take this time to celebrate the lives of all trans people. Anyone who lives in their truth as a trans person, their life is worthy of a celebration. So let this night not only mark a memorial, but a celebration of a new journey for the trans community that we're preparing for. We're ready for a new journey because tonight we decide we will no longer live in fear. We don't need acceptance from anyone but ourselves. If you accept yourself, I accept you. If you love yourself, I love you. And for my trans brothers and sisters that are struggling and weak, if you're not strong enough to love yourself, we got you. I love you enough for all of us. And together, in unity as we stand, we will eliminate this list of names. So now we can please have a moment of silence. Thank you.
This time, Tisha Menifee will be coming up with a reflection message for us.
Good evening, everyone. As we close up on the day, I just want to say that there's a song that I've been thinking about all day as we've been preparing for this event. There's a song by Molly Music that says, I got my walking shoes on, and I can't tell you where I'm going, but I'm walking down this lonely road, and the scenery is so beautiful. But I know that if I just keep walking, I will reach my dream. My prayer tonight is that we continue to walk in the shoes that have been perfectly designed for each and every one of us. Tailor-made within the image of the greater than ourselves. Some call him God, some call it spirit, some call it universe. Tonight, let's call it love. As we leave this space, knowing that we can never part from love, I pray that we continue to love ourselves, our family, our community. My prayer is that we gain strength as we become more aware of the disparities of our community and those abroad. And as an act of love, we continue to change from within so that we can be better, a better person, making a better community, creating a better world. Ashe.
At this time, Carter Brown, the Transmen Incorporated, will be coming for our closing remarks.
I'd like to thank you all again for coming out tonight. You could have been doing anything, but you chose to be a catalyst for change. You chose to come and be a voice, a face, for those that no longer have a voice, for those whose faces are no longer on earth with us because they were victims of hatred, victims of anti-trans violence. We thank you for being a catalyst for change. We thank you for joining our side as we walk every day struggling for acceptance of our family, our friends, acceptance to use the bathroom when we need to use the bathroom. We struggle for acceptance in a job interview. We struggle for acceptance in shelters. When we're homeless, we have nowhere to go as trans people. We thank you for showing up tonight and joining us to be a catalyst for change. We need you, our friends and allies. We need you to walk with us to be a catalyst for change. Tonight, we memorialized young people, more mature people, various ethnicities, various gender identities, but the common denominator was that they were a part of our community. This is not just a trans remembrance. This is our cry out in unity for action, for change, for equality. And it takes all of us to have you all here as allies, friends, family members, makes us even stronger. And we thank you for joining us to be a catalyst for change.
I am so glad that he said catalyst for change, because I skipped ahead of myself. At this time, Trayshawn Pitt will be coming up. And if you all have your TDOR papers on there, is a catalyst for change pledge. And as we depart tonight, we'd like for you all to repeat after him as he comes up and say that, as he says that.
Please repeat after me. Today we accept the opportunity.
Today we accept the opportunity.
To embrace hatred and indifference with love and respect.
To embrace hatred and indifference with love and respect.
We pledge our voices that they may be of service to others who have no voice being heard.
We pledge our voices to love and respect.
We vow to love, accept, and protect.
We vow to love, accept, and protect.
Our community, regardless of their ethnicity,
sexual orientation,
gender, or sex.
Today we stand and commit ourselves
to be a catalyst for change within our community.
To be a catalyst for change within our community.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
At this time, for those of you that would like to transition with us over to the Dallas Resource Blue Yellow Room, we have refreshments over there for fellowship. Miss Underwood is on her way, so if you all would like to meet her, she will be arriving there at the Resource Center due to the timing. Once again, I would like to thank you all for attending the Transgender Day of Remembrance 2015 here at the Legacy of Love Monument. I'd like to extend my thanks personally to each and every one of you, to Candace the Greatest, to Ashley Boucher, to Cosette Kosari, and all of the others that I may not have mentioned personally. And you also, Mr. Michael Milligan of the Oakland Committee, for allowing us to have this event here. Thank you all once again, and we hope to see you all at the Resource Center, the Blue-Yellow Room. Thank you.
Hopefully your favorite videographer from Two Hats Publishing. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like it, please leave comments below or like, follow, or subscribe to us and get notices of all our videos. We love it, even when you call.